Hello everyone, myself Sanjivi Kalkini, and the topic which I'm going to carry today is transport and distribution of abscisic acid. Then upcoming subtitles are introduction, abscisic acid in root, abscisic acid in leaves, root abscisic acid reach the xylem, abscisic acid in stem, and the last is conclusion. The first topic, the first heading is introduction. Introduction. Abscisic acid is a hormonal stress signal that moves in the xylem from the root to the different parts of the shoot, where it regulates transpiration, water loss of leaf growth. The role and physiological significance of the ABA that is transported in the xylem sap from the roots to the shoot as a stress signal during earlier stress is well established. Increased attention has been paid in the past of the factors that regulate the intensity of the hormone signal in the xylem. The next is abscisic acid in roots. Abscisic acid in the root increase as the soil is dry and is derived to a significant extent from synthesis in the root tissues. Both tissue types of root, stem, steel and cortex possess an equal capacity of synthesis ABA even at water losses of 50% and more. The largest accumulation is often observed in the root tips. It is very likely a result of the low vascularization of the root tips cell with a high percentage of cytosol that compartment where ABA is formed. Next is abscisic acid in leaves. A soil stress, phosphate deficiency and ammonium nutrition enhance the percentage of recirculation of abscisic acid. ABA and ABA glucose ester has been detected in the soil solution under a range of crop plants at concentration up to 10 nm or 30 nm. Root abscisic acid reaches the xylem. Xylem ABA concentration are strongly affected by changes of radial water flow in the root causes caused by transpiration. When ABA is transported in the simplest exclusively effluents from the xylem parenchyma cell across the plasma membrane to the apoplast and the xylem vesicle is a rate limiting step. Lateral water flow caused by transpiration will dilute the ABA dramatically and change its stomatal opening. As a result of light-induced stomatal oscillation will cause a huge concentration change of ABA and ABA in stem. A very little is taken about the fate of ABA during its transport in the xylem through the stem. The free ABA can be fed into the xylem from stem parenchyma when ABA is low. When ABA in the stem parenchyma is high and when pH increase. On the other hand, ABA can be redistributed to the stem parenchyma essentially when ABA is high. So this free ABA, conjugated ABA, is also transported in the xylem. Because of its hydrophilic properties, this molecule is different from free ABA, transported without any losses or enrichment through the stem. The last is conclusion. Abscisic acid flux in the xylem can be regulated by several factors on the way from the root to the target cell in the shoot. These factors include anatomically, physiologically, and biochemical factors in the tissues of the root, stem, and leaves. Thank you all for your patience. Thank you, ma'am.